motherfuckers, pretty much, they just work just to support their wickedness in the world. So they're putting everything else before the Lord. Like we said before, when their destruction cometh, then that's when they want to seek the Lord. When they end up in the ER under the knife, then they want to seek the Lord. You know, when a bus is on top of them, then they want to seek the Lord. Lose a family member, then they want to seek the Lord. You know, when they catch that incurable gonorrhea, then they gonna want to seek the Lord. Quick message. What's the quick message? Quick message. Oh, quick message. Tell them to get the message. That's the message. Get up.
And what's that scripture, the race and not given to the switch or something like that?
Paul, that's Paul.
Yeah, but I can't find
I'll
it.
I'll find it.
Because, does your boy want to get it quick? You can't get it quick. There ain't no quick route, you know what I mean? But once you start studying, the Lord will raise you up quickly. He ain't gonna do it in a day. You know, I was studying for like a year before I went out and started teaching. You know what I mean? That's how I make, because you got to make sure you know everything right. You can't just get the truth in one sentence.
1 Corinthians 9,
round 24. I got the 40. Yeah, get that one.
Yeah, that's a bad scripture.
He said everybody moving fast. Well, I guess it's not for them. You're going to have to slow it down. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, I got another scripture on that too.
All right.
The busybody scripture. Here we go. I'm going to start at 9 and 10.
Yeah, because each thing that you study and teach upon, you got to go over with a fine-tooth comb. You just got to go over it again and again and again and again. You know what I mean? There ain't no quick nothing. Go ahead.
Lord said, he it altogether for our sakes, no doubt, this is written, that he that ploweth should plow in hope, and that he that thresheth and hope should be partaker of his hope. If we have sown unto you spiritual things, that it is a great thing, if we shall reap your carnal things. If others be partakers of this power over you, or not we rather, nevertheless, we have not used this power, but suffer all things, lest we should hinder the gospel of the anointed. Do ye not know that they which minister about holy things live of the things of the temple, and they which wait at the altar are partakers with the altar? Amen. Oh, wait a minute, I started late back then.
Yeah.
22, to the weak became I as weak, that I might gain the weak. I am made all things to all men, that I might by all means save more some. Is this I do for the gospel, for the gospel's sake, that I might be partakers thereof with you? Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize, so run that ye may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I therefore so run, not as uncertain. So fight I not as the one that beateth the air, but I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest they that by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway. That's the end of that chapter.
So you ain't gonna. Because us, when we get this truth, when we be running with it, we be getting that knowledge, you know what I'm saying? You just ain't going to understand everything in one day. I mean, the scriptures say it's a spirit of quickeneth, but it ain't going to happen just like that. Like, your boy thought he could get the whole truth in one tweet. You know what I mean? Just in one sentence.
Lord said, follow me, make you fishers of men. He taught us how to become fishers of men. And part of behind the scenes of becoming fishers of men is us being at home studying. You know?
You're right.
Studying.
And we go hard on it too. Like I said, we got sleepless nights, bro. You know how many nights I've been up studying? Up till 5, 6 in the morning, the sun is up chirping. You just be up just in the spirit, bro. You don't even, you be mad that you gotta go to sleep. Like, damn, you be cursing your body. Like, why I gotta go to sleep? This is some bullshit. You know what I mean? Right? You get into the good part of the study and your body getting tired. You gotta go to sleep.
Here we go. Yeah, I'm gonna blow this one as well. brother. This is 2 Thessalonians 3 and 6. Now we command you, brethren, the point is way down level. Now we command you, brethren, in the name of our Lord, Yahalashai, that ye withdraw yourself from every brother that walk disorderly, and not after the tradition which he received of us. For yourselves know how ye ought to follow us, for we behave not ourselves disorderly among you, neither did we eat any man's bread for naught, but wrought with labor and travail night and day. I like that right there. That's like what you're saying. Birds be chirping, you know, you're in the middle of your star, yep. You're in the middle of your star, you're studying.
Yeah.
Time just flies, you know?
Right. You ain't got enough time to study. You know, that's, but in the kingdom, we're going to have all the knowledge, you know what I'm saying? That's what we hoping for. See, a lot of people, they can't wait to get the kingdom so they can finally get some pussy. You know what I mean?
The carnal, they only look for the carnal shit.
I'm looking for the mystery, bro, and I want the mystery.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, the women's good too, you know, but. Yeah.
I want to know how all this was made.
Yeah, I want to, yeah, you know. Right. I want to know that the deep hidden mystery.
Right, that's what we're waiting for.
And we're going, all going to be revealed to us.
Yeah,
in the kingdom, we'll be able to watch, you know, the ancient battles, you know, on a big screen or so. How are the Most High going to let us see? He going to reveal all them ancient mysteries to us. Things that have been hidden for ages, you know what I mean?
But work with labor and travail night and day, that we might not be chargeable to any of you. Not because we have not power, but to make ourselves an example to you to follow us. For even when we were with you, this we commanded you, that if any would not work, neither should he eat. For we hear that there are some which walk among you disorderly, working not at all, but are busybodies.
That's talking about, you know, they're not doing the work in the mold. This is work right here. This is the work that you're supposed to be worried about. That working ain't talking about going to McDonald's. You know what I'm saying?
No, busybodies, man. Just everything else is more important than.
Right, because you think the Lord went and had a job at a warehouse driving a forklift? No, he didn't. He wasn't employed. He was on the streets teaching the gospel. He even told the disciples, Peter and Peter and John. He told them they was out fishing. They was at work. He's like, you put them damn nets down. Come and follow me. Now I'm gonna make you fishers of men.
What did you tell his mom and dad? I'm about my dad's, my father's business.
I'm about my father's business.
No. He told his mom and dad that at 12.
Yep. Oh, he even when it came to the money.
Right.
He said, whose image is on that coin?
Yep.
Not
Caesar.
Mine.
Caesar.
Give unto Caesar was due to Caesar. Give unto the Lord was due to the Lord. Saying, pretty much telling you that money means shit. He said, lay up yourself treasures in heaven. Now, don't lay your treasures on the earth where moth and rust doth corrupt.
Great thing, laying a treasure in that 401k.
Yeah, forward. And when a thief, a Jew thief, Esau gonna come and take it.
You got his eyes on it, don't you?
They can't steal our treasure. Our treasure is in our spirit, in our mind, that knowledge. You can't steal that treasure. You can't get it. It's unattainable. You know that probably pisses Esau off too.
A little bit more. Now them that are such, we command and exhort by our Lord Yahawashai, the anointed, that with quietness they work and eat their own bread. But ye, brethren, be not worldly and well-doing. And if any man obey not our word by this epistle, note that man and have no company with him, that he may be ashamed.
That's why you gotta, note that man, bro. You see some people out here.
Quick message.
Quick message. Structure's coming soon.
We know, hey.
Hey, they wanted the quick message, we'll give it to them, you know what I mean?
Quick message,
you're gonna be destroyed.
Well, we've heard it all.
Hey, let's get that message.
It keeps coming. Shit that you new shit, man.
Hey, let's get the quick message real quick. I got a quick message.
Oh yeah, super structure.
Proverbs 13:13. Whoso despiseth the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. So there's a quick message. I mean, you want to boil it down to the most basics. You know what I mean? But then they get offended when you read that. But bro, now you just say we're going to be destroyed. You know they have a problem with anything you say.
2 Timothy 2 Timothy 2 and 4. No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affair of this life, that he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier. If a man also strive for masteries, yet is he not crowned except he strive lawfully.
Yeah, we strive for this truth, bro. It's like, yeah, how you gonna be good at something? Do you think Jordan got good at playing basketball by just sitting on his ass? Or he just got a couple quick shots in, right?
Yeah, right, right.
You know, just real quick. Right. No, they say he practiced more than anybody they had ever seen. Sitting there shooting free throws for hours and hours and hours. Just constantly practicing. That's how he became the best. So if you wanna get good with these scriptures, you gotta study. You gotta work hard at it. That's all people's problem. They don't want to work hard at nothing. And that's why you, in your life you become nothing.
Oh, yeah, man. The scripture says that that trying your faith works patience, right?
Yeah.
So
patience, yeah, you got to have patience.
Yeah. So how are you going to give the word to
him? Oh, we got to look at the word patience.
You give the word to him, and the shit hits the fan, and then some tribulation happens to him, and he won't have patience to endure what's coming. That's why you got to get tried. That's also part of the word, get tried.
Get tried.
So you can have patience. He didn't get tried. He went
for
quick shit.
Yeah, patience is key. Patience goes hand in hand with faith. To be faithful, you have to have great patience. Yeah. Look at this hell we're enduring.
That chip comes. They play, hey, get the chip or get your head chopped off.
They gonna take the chip.
Yeah, they gonna call the name of the Lord. They gonna think that's something. But you gotta get tried. You gotta get tried to fix the shit.
Oh, you remember this one? Talking about some patience, it's like. There's a lot of scriptures on patience.
Some scripture things are difficult.
Which one did you just drop here?
The I hear drop is just some fucking cheap ass phone that ain't good.
Well, this says 2 Peter 1 and 6. Let me just get all of 2 Peter 1. Yeah, that's that demon.
Yeah.
Little babies got demons in them.
Yeah. See, they pray for monsters.
That's scripture.
That's right. Well, here we go.
You say, where you at?
Oh,
okay. I'll get that 2 Peter.
Oh, this is bad. Patience. Enduring without complaint.
Your boy was complaining, wasn't he? He was complaining.
Right.
You know why, I can't get it quick. Complaining, bro. You gotta be patient.
Bearing, supporting, suffering, enduring, permitting.
Enduring. You gotta endure, man.
What's that?
When you're trying to get somewhere on a destination, you going on a long trip. It takes like 2 hours to get to Cleveland. But you know what I'm saying? If you can't sit and wait, it takes too long for you to get there, then you're like, I can't even go there. Now, how you going to get there if you ain't got patience? Don't make no sense. 2 Peter, you done with that?
Oh, yeah, I'm done.
All right. 2 Peter 1 and 1. Simon Peter, a servant and apostle of Yahushua Mashiach, to them that have obtained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of our God and our Savior, Yahawashai. Grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Yahawashai our Lord, according as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue. In virtue, you know, virtue, that's, you know, that really comes from the word truth. Whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature. Oh, check that out. Having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. Ooh, that's bad, ain't it? If the world is corrupted through lust, that's all people do. They lusting after everything, lusting after riches. They lusting after your wife, lusting after your car stereo. You know, everything you got, they want to get it. And they're going to come, they're going to rob you, pull a pistol on you, and you know, they're just going to take it. Nah, they don't ever come up like come and get that wisdom, motherfuckers. You gonna get it. They don't care about no wisdom. They got the only wisdom they into is how to hit a lick successfully and get away with it. That's their wisdom. You know what I mean? Yeah, I've been sitting my whole life. I done heard I could probably be a professional thief with all the knowledge I gained from Two Thirds. You know what I mean? Man, they got every stone. What do you call it? No stone is left unturned for these motherfuckers. And they get away with some, well, a lot of them are stupid. They don't even think about it. But some of our people, they're experts at thieving and killing. They experts at killing. You got some Jakes walk around here and got 50 bodies on them. Yep. Man, expert at it.
Never been caught. Death angels.
Yep.
Death angels. Go to prison, come out even better, smarter, more wise.
And besides this, giving all diligence. Oh, you gotta get diligence. Add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge. And check this out. And to knowledge temperance, and to temperance patience, and to patience godliness. So you know what I'm saying? When it comes to knowledge, you gotta have temperance. And temperance, I believe that comes from the word time, don't it? Tempo is Spanish for time. The temperate, that means time. You gotta keep tempo, you gotta keep time. You know what I mean? And to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. There ain't no brotherly kindness out here. These motherfuckers will come up, roll up on you, just steal on you just for fun. You know what I mean? Yeah. Just knocking people out just for kicks. Oh, that was funny.
You see the way he hit the ground?
And then they post it on Facebook. They so stupid, they post themselves committing crimes on Facebook. Yeah, fucking retards, man.
Light the mile up, bro. You want to light
it? Go ahead, bring that up. See if I was right. I know I was right.
Temperance from Etymology said temperance, mid 4th century, self restraint, moderation, Anglo French, temperance, mid moderation, sobriety,
yeah.
Discretion, self control.
What is a Latin root word?
Latin.
What's it say?
It says Latin.
Y'all have the etymology on there? You gotta, let me see. Oh, you on Etymology? That's the best site. You just gotta go to temper. And I believe it's going to take you back to time.
Modern is...
But look, it goes to temple. Temple. And the measuring compared to temple. Temporal, yes, it is Latin. Tempest, time, season. The tempest, time, and that's where you get the word temple, too. And what's this thing right here on your head called? That's your temple, because the temple is in your mind. That's why that part of your head's called a temple. Because the true temple of the Lord is right there in your mind. Not in a building. So yeah, you gotta use temperance, man. You can't be hasty just to... You gotta use your mind, bro.
Hey. Trying to get everything one time.
Yeah, you get fucked out doing that. You ain't gonna get
burnt out.
Shit, I'm terrible. I'll spend months on end just on one topic. Would I be studying just history or something? And that dude asked a big question. He said, where did all the white people come from? That's at least an hour lesson just to get started.
Man, you gotta explain the Gentile side, you gotta explain the other Gentile side. I mean, good God, and he ain't gonna get it.
The Genesis 25 is a long chapter too. Read all that. Then you gotta go into Esau's blessing. Man, when you try to go through that whole break, you can't even make it through that breakdown on the streets. You gotta do a sit-down class. Just to try to break it down out here, you're gonna get interrupted. You ain't gonna be able to finish. But that's the beauty of the scriptures though. It's not for everybody.
Some stuff vision reaches from one end to another mighty, and sweetly does she order all things. I loved her and sought her out from my youth, for I desired to make her my spouse, and I was a lover of her beauty.
Right, that's my woman, is wisdom. And the scriptures in the Greek, they call wisdom has a female name, Sophia. That's where you get that word Sophia, means wisdom. So that's supposed to be the main woman. That's supposed to be your wife.
And that she has come to conversation with the Most High. She magnified her nobility. Yea, the Lord of all things himself loved her. And she is privy to the mysteries.
Oh, but your boy Bubble Eye, I'm sorry, Bubble Eye Blackfish will read that and he'll say that the Holy Spirit is a woman. When this is just metaphorical speech, it doesn't mean it's actually a woman. Just like because I call my boat a woman or my car a girl, doesn't mean it's actually female. B.B. King called his guitar Lucille. That doesn't mean his guitar actually had a gender. You know what I mean? Same thing, that's parabolic talk. Huh?
What makes Lucille a gender?
I can't understand.
You just said B.B. King had a guitar which he called Lucille.
Well, no, Lucille. It was Lucille. Well, I mean, it's a metaphor, you know what I mean? Because a lot of people can't understand. I got a scripture for that. Check this out. There's a lot of people don't understand that metaphorical speech. The Lord set it up like that. Where is that? Let me get Matthew 13. I got it. Never mind. Matthew 13:9. Who had the ears to hear, let him hear. And the disciples came and said unto him, Why speakest thou unto them in parables? He answered and said unto them, Because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. Yeah, that's a beautiful scripture. Because it's not. We speak of parables, and the Lord speaks of parables, just so everybody can't get it. Some people, they so simple, they just can't get it. And I was looking for one of Mark, though. There's a good one of Mark, too. I was just reading it this morning. Go ahead.
2 Peter 3:16. Also, in all his epistles, speaking in them as these things, in which are some things hard to be understood, which they that are unlearned and unstable rest, as they do also the other scriptures, unto their own destruction.
Right, because like the scriptures say, you got to suck on the breasts. Meaning, when you first come into the truth, you got to be reborn like a baby. And you can't feed a baby steaks. You got to feed them, breast milk. And the breast milk in the scriptures is referring to the simple things to understand, like knowing the Lord's name. You know what I'm saying? That's part of that milk. Knowing that you're an Israelite, okay? That's part of that milk. And after you get that and you start growing in faith and growing in the truth, you get older, then you can start eating the steak and eating them good meals, you know what I mean? Sure. It's harder to digest.
I'm gonna go on to that. All right. Isaiah 28:7. But they also have erred through wine and through strong drink. Are out of the way. The priests and the prophets have erred through strong drink. They are swallowed up of wine. They are out of the way through strong drink. They err in vision. They stumble in judgment. For all tables are full of vomit and filthiness, so that there is no place clean.
That's our people's tables when they eat.
They were told they don't know no better.
See, there's another parable too. That's talking about an actual table.
That's right. That's bad. Yeah, that's right. Whom shall he teach knowledge? That's a question.
The Lord said, to whom shall he teach knowledge?
And whom shall he make to understand doctrine?
That's a good question. It's not everybody, I know that.
Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast.
Because a lot of our people, they can get the milk. They can understand that they're Israelite, and they might know the Lord's name. That's about as deep as they can go. We try to give them some meat. We start talking about UFOs or something, and they'll bug out. You gotta
perform a Heimlich.
You gotta do a Heimlich.
A spiritual Heimlich.
You shoot it back up out of there. It starts choking.
For precept must be upon precept. precept upon precept, line upon line, care a little and bear a little.
Right.
For with stammering lips and another tongue will he speak to his people, to whom he said, this is the rest wherewith ye may cause the weary to rest, and this is the refreshing, yet they would not hear. Jesus.
They ain't gonna hear. I got a precept for you. You still got more?
Oh, I'll
go ahead.
But the word of the Lord was upon him, precept upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little and there a little, that they might go and fall backward and be broken and snared and taken. Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
They got him up in there.
Oh, wow. They got him.
He did like OJ
something,
bro. Daddy!
He don't understand that he's a real one. He don't need to be wearing that
little hat. Because the Bible actually says when you prophesy, you're supposed to keep your head uncovered. That's why them fake Jews, you see them Jews, they wear the little funny hats, the yarmulkes, the kippahs, because they in total opposition to the scriptures. So the scriptures say keep your head uncovered, they covered. You know what I mean?
Something called a straw, prayer shawl.
Yeah. Prayer shawl?
Yeah, when you pray, they can
feel your head. Listen to this, bro.
Yeah, they actually worship Satan. That's part of the trick.
This is 1 Corinthians 11 and 4. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonors his head.
Yeah, because those fake Jews, they're not even real Jews, but that's why they wear the little kippahs. Sometimes they got these big giant woolly hats or whatever, all them funny hats they wear. The script, they just wear that in the temple. They say you can't even go in a temple with your head uncovered. That's totally against the scriptures. Totally against them.
That's
you know, that's an old custom of Jake, too, up in the hood, whatever. You praying, everybody take your hat off. You know what I mean? And now our people still have that custom. That goes back to the scriptures. Yeah, you're not allowed to wear a hat in the house. My grandma was like that. Yep, you ain't allowed to wear it. Yep. That was considered disrespectful.
They don't allow you to wear hats in school?
Nope, no hats in school. That all goes back from them customs. They ain't gonna get rid of it though. They trying to phase all of our customs out, bro. Alright, Dev. Huh? Right, you know what I'm saying? That was sound.
Hey, what's up, brothers?
What's up?
Alright.
I got a precept real quick. This is real short. Hebrews 5 and 12. For when the time ye ought to be teachers, this is really going out to all these false teachers, Nathaniel, all these churches, all these people, bro. These little purple people y'all see out here. For the time ye ought to be teachers, you have need that one teach you again. A lot of these people, they come out, man, you can wonder about yourself. A lot of these people out here, they think they already know the truth. They're like, my pastor told me. You know what I mean? But when the time you ought to be teachers, you have need that one teach you again, which be the first principles of the oracles of the Most High, and are become such as have need of milk and not of strong meat. For everyone that useth milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. But strong meat belongeth to them that are full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercise to discern both good and evil.
That's bad.
See, that's us. You know what I'm saying? We out here, we eat the steaks, bro. You know what I mean? The big slabs. You know what I'm saying?
We eat whole lambs.
But that's why your boy too said that every week we come out here and people are always asking, what's the difference between us and the purple guy? And notice the purple guy no longer come out on the same day as us. Because they know when we come out here, and they avoid us at all costs.
I mean, we couldn't even give him a quick answer for that.
Nope. But them dudes over there, the purple guys, IUIC, they're unskillful in the word, okay? Okay, what's that scripture?
They choke on the milk.
Right, they choke on the milk. they drowned themselves by a couple drops of milk. But yeah, them dudes, they ain't never ate no steak before. You see what I'm saying? They can't eat the steak. All they have is, they know they're Israelites, and that's about all they know. They know Deuteronomy 28, and they don't even know all of that. They might just know a couple scriptures. That's a long chapter. They ain't read the whole chapter. All they doing, they just stuck on repeat like a parrot. You know what I mean? That's all they know, bro. And that's it.
Well, I can't break that down.
Well, hell no. Yeah, well, obviously they don't study because they mock the Hebrew language. So if you mocking the Hebrew language, but you call yourself a Hebrew Israelite, that's a paradox. That's a paradox. Paradox.
Here we go, back to these riches. If riches be in possession to be desired in this life, what is richer than wisdom that worketh all things? And if prudence work, who of all that are is a more cunning workman than she?
Right.
And if a man love righteousness, her labors are virtue.
Yeah, because true riches is the knowledge. So, I mean, you see all these rich, famous people, they get all that money and they're still not satisfied. They still feel empty inside. But when you get this knowledge and this truth, this is that real riches, and it sustains your soul and your spirit. It keeps you going.
Well, me, how these motherfuckers get riches and go to Africa.
Then they come right back.
Come back empty. Go to Africa. What the fuck is Africa for, man?
I got a precept for you real quick.
Amongst a bunch of nations, they don't even want you there.
She might catch AIDS over there.
AIDS and Ebola. It's crazy. All these motherfuckers get money and go straight to Africa.
And then they don't even want you over there. They're watching you the whole time. Isaiah 33 and is that right? 33 and 6. Isaiah 33 and 6. And wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times and strength of salvation. The fear of Yahweh is his treasure. So yeah, Yahweh, that's the name of the Most High God. God's name is not God. God's name is not Lord. Okay, it's not Yahweh. It's your house.
What if anybody know that 13-year-old boy got shot the other day?
Oh, they know.
You think so? I don't know.
we was talking about that Columbus is a special kind of retard.
Yeah, they're special. Straight up.
Don't expect no riots here no time soon. Only when they cut off the EBT, then they'll go nuts. Because you got a lot of obesity out here.
Oh, yeah. I noticed since then, man, a lot of churches have been profiting off of that shooting, too.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
A lot of churches, everybody going to church. You know? Whatever, I don't know. Who knows what they're talking about?
The church, hey, if you like being destroyed,
stay peaceful.
If you want to seal your destruction, go to church. The Lord will get you for sure then.
Stay peaceful. Love the Lord.
They just didn't tell you that their God was Baal. That's what they forgot to tell you.
Pray for Tyree King.
The scripture said, pray not for this people. You ain't supposed to pray for these wicked people. These little bastard children running around there are evil. You see them every day. You gotta watch with. You see a gang of these little bastards come up on you. You can't be trusting them.
For she teaches temperance and prudence, justice and fortitude, which are such things as men can have nothing more profitable in their life. If a man desire much experience, she knoweth things of old and conjureth the right what is to come. She knoweth the subtleties of speeches and can expound dark sentences.
A dark sentence. Man, we go into them dark sayings, you know what I mean? It's not for everybody, okay? This word is not for everybody. That's why it's written. The Bible is pretty much written in code. You know, when it gets to the prophecies and, like I said, the dark sentences of sayings, it's not meant for everybody to see.
Dark sentences, for she foreseeth signs and wonders and the events of seasons and times. Therefore, I propose to take her to me to live, knowing that she will be a counselor of good things and a comfort in cares and grief. For her sake, I shall have estimation among the multitude and honor the elders, though I be young. I shall be found of a quick conceit and judgment, and shall be admired in the sight of great men. When I hold my tongue, they shall bide my leisure, and when I speak, they shall give ear unto me. If I talk much, they shall lay their hands upon their mouth. We say some things, people like, oh, shit, I can't believe they said that. And they take it as offensive, some things. That's funny, it says, they shall lay their hands upon their mouth. Lord, but by the means of her, I shall obtain immortality and leave behind me an everlasting abundance that come after me. I shall set the people in order, and the nations shall be subject unto me.
The nations, but the Lord loves all people, right? But when we get in the kingdom of heaven, all these heathen nations, they're going to be our servants.
Honorable tyrants shall be afraid. Horrible tyrants shall be afraid when they do but hear of me. I shall be found good among the multitude and now of the Lord. That's just what the scripture says, how the name of the Lord is dreadful among the heathen. For after I am come into my house, I will repose myself with her. For her conversation hath no bitterness, and to live with her hath no sorrow, but mirth and joy. And they ain't talking about no woman. Now when I consider these things in myself, and pardon them in my heart, how that to be allied unto wisdom is immortality, a great pleasure it is to have a friendship, and in the works of your hands are infinite riches, and in the exercise of conference with her prudence, and in talking with her a good report. I went about seeking about how to take her to me. For I was a witty child and had a good spirit. Yea, brethren, being good, I came into a body of the power. Nevertheless, when I perceived that I could not otherwise obtain her, except the Most High gave her me, and that was a point of wisdom also to know whose gift she was. Now, I mean, that just cut, you know, these motherfuckers just can't go out and teach themselves the scriptures and become a prophet.
It's a gift.
Yeah, it's a gift.
He gives it to whomso he pleases.
That's right.
There's a scripture after
that. Let me go into that too. Yeah. Let me finish this at the end anyway. I pray unto the Lord and besought him, and with my whole heart I say.
I got more of them dark sayings and stuff.
Right.
Psalm 78. Give ear, O my people, to my law. Oh.
Listen. That says he's saying, listen.
Yeah, what's the law? The law is what? Obviously, thou shalt not kill, steal. Thou shalt not commit adultery. They definitely don't keep that law. You ain't supposed to be eating pork. Okay, that's against the laws of the Bible. The Bible says you're not supposed to eat pork. You ain't supposed to be eating shrimp. No catfish.
Possum.
No possum. They'll eat the possum, bro. They be eating rabbits. He always hear me, I'm making some rabbit stew. That was good, boy. Threw some squirrel in there with it. You know what I mean? Eating. Yeah, they don't like to keep the law of the Lord. And then they hate it when you tell them about it. They despise you for it. My heart, I only can talk to God because that's me. Fuck you talk about. Give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings of old, which we have heard and known, and our fathers have told us. We will not hide them for their children, showing to the generation to come the praises of Yahweh and his strength and his wonderful works that he hath done. He hath established a testimony in Jacob and appointed a law in Israel, which he commanded our fathers that they should make them known to their children. I'm talking about the Israelites. Because the law was only given to the nation of Israel. The Bible was only given to the nation of Israel, and nobody else.
That's it.
That's what you got. I'm sorry, I didn't know what y'all. I couldn't stop it.
That's all good, dog. That's good.
Well, I had some crazy ass.
This is He saw where he was to take the pictures. That's an Edomite too.
Oh, shit.
Did you guys marry and change it all? She's pregnant. We're trying to get some money.
Sorry, bro. I got to go. Like that out here in America. That's all. It's brother against brother. You know what I mean? Dog eat dog. That's what it is. A saying says it's a dog eat dog world. You know what I mean? Everybody for himself. And that's pretty much the main principles of America. Is America's all about the individuals. Every man for himself. They always preach the individualism, which is I got it. Individualism. That's the main philosophy of Satanism. You know what I mean? It's all about the individual. You got more to that?
Henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth. But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father I have made known to you. Ye have not chosen me. I have chosen you.
Right, that's why you be going to church. You know, the pastor be like, do you accept Jesus in your heart, Sister Mary? It don't work like that. You don't get to choose the Lord. The scriptures clearly say that the Lord chooses you. You do not choose him. And that also disproves free will. There is no such thing as free will. Free will does not exist. All you have is the illusion of free will. You thought you made a choice. No, you just program. We're all programmed, even with us. We got no control of what we do. The Lord had us come out here and teach his word. It wasn't even up to us. The Lord said he had chosen the elect before the earth was even created.
Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you, that ye should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain.
But how do you bring forth fruit? You gotta go work in the fields. You gotta go work in the harvest. Now we out here. This is the wheat field right here. We out here harvesting.
Yeah, but it also says in the Bible, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me.
Exactly.
So therefore, you choose rather if you want to go to Jesus Christ.
There's no choice.
God the Father.
Let me read this again. Listen.
That's what it is. Red letters.
Listen. This is John 15:16. Yet. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you. That's not everybody. He's talking to the elect, a certain elect of people. Not everyone. You know, because you know, I actually heard the church read this scripture to their people in the congregation. Like, ooh, ah, in the spirit, like the Lord had chosen.
I said it's an illusion of free will. You think you got that free will, but it's not. It's really, the Lord controls everything. Okay, everything.
Let me get that real quick.
The Lord creates the good and the evil. Okay?
But you choose rather not if you go to the kingdom of God. So you choose rather.
You ain't got no choice.
There ain't no choice. Listen to this. This is Job 33:14. Listen carefully. For God speaketh once, yea twice, yet man perceiveth it not. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls upon men.
Oh, yeah. Hey, we ain't brought this one out in a minute.
When deep sleep falls upon men and slumberings upon the bed, then he openeth the ears of men and sealeth their instructions. So when you go lay down, the angels, they get in your mind and program. Because we ain't number programs. We ain't number robots. We all of us are robots.
In the eyes of God.
I got one.
Not all of us, some of us.
I'm going to get this preset real quick.
Not all of us.
I got another one for you, bro. Check this out. Proverbs 20 and 24. Man's goings are of the Lord. How can a man then understand his own way?
Perfect precept upon precept. Precept upon precept.
Man's goings, his ways are of the Lord. How can he understand his own way?
Right.
So in your mind, you think there's free will. You're making choices. Yeah, of course you're making choices. But at the end of the day, that was just an illusion that you made that choice.
Right. All of us have remote control cars, right? You can pat that motherfucker to go any way you want.
And you get bugged.
But my argument is also saying that it also states in the Bible, you should have faith as a little as a mustard seed. What is a mustard seed?
Well, what's that to do with what we're talking about?
It has a lot to do.
Go ahead.
When you said that we do not get to choose God.
Did you just hear the scripture we read?
I heard what the scripture said.
You don't understand it?
I do understand it.
Do you know what predestination is?
Kind of, sort of.
Let me hit you with a scripture, bro. Let me get at Ephesians real quick.
I got one too.
Where does you have faith in the Lord and God Jesus Christ?
What is faith? What is faith?
Faith is what you make.
Hey, faith is a gift, man.
Faith is what you make. So if you believe in Him.
Let me ask you a question. It says, scripture says faith is a gift. Can you choose what your gift, give somebody, gives you something?
This is it's a mystery though. Check this out. Ephesians 1:1-4. According as He hath chosen us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before Him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Yahweh Shai is the true name of the Lord, okay? It's not Jesus. As having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Yahweh Shai Mashiach to Himself, according to the good pleasure of His will. So if we was predestined, check this out. The Lord predestinated us before the earth was created. That means we was already chosen before the earth was created. That means He already chose. There is no choice. The script done been written.
But you made my point, though.
How did I make your point?
Because you said predestination. You said this God, we was already chosen.
Exactly, we were chosen. So we didn't make the
all
choice.
All of us is God chosen, no matter what it is. You said predestination. So
you just caught yourself. But he said he was chosen.
I get what he's saying.
So he said somebody was chosen.
He said everybody. As we God's, we are made out of God's eyes and God's image, and God's image only.
We're made after the God's plural image. The scripture said we made them after our image. That's another mystery. See, as you gotta forget all that old stuff you learned, bro.
This scripture, Sirach 18:3. The Lord only is righteous, and there is none other but He, who governeth the world with the palm of His hand, and all things obey His will. For He is the King of all, by His power dividing holy things among them from prevent.
Yeah, so the Lord created everything for His own will, you know what I mean? It's the Lord's will that brings forth all the evil.
There was no beginning, though, until God set the beginning.
Exactly, not man.
Man was created, which was Adam and Eve, through his own image, through dust. Okay, through dust and water, He made us.
We know that.
So, if we're not chosen, then who is?
But who is chosen?
That's my question.
Well, who's the Lord's chosen people? The nation of Israel. And that's it. Well, that's not that. That's a giant multitude of people right there.
You don't agree?
I agree to some point soon.
But
there's
always a but.
I was raised Catholic.
That's the problem.
It's Catholic.
Catholic is what you make.
What does the word mean, though, Catholic?
I don't study Catholic.
We know what it means.
I don't study Catholic.
Catholic means universal.
Christians. I follow Christian actually.
But the Catholic Church is pagan, though. They celebrate Christmas. You know about Christmas? Christmas is actually the high holy day of Baal, a.k.a. Satan. Okay, that's why they put a Christmas tree in the house. What does a Christmas tree represent? It's a grove, which represents Baal. And it's all through the scriptures. And the Lord tells us that the Israelites were being wicked, and they were putting groves in their house, and they was worshiping Baal. That's what Christmas is.
What Bible are you studying now?
The only Bible. There's only one Bible.
There's the King James Version.
That's the English Bible. Okay. I got a Hebrew Bible in my book bag.
Okay, you got a Hebrew.
That's the original source.
Bible, right?
Okay, right. And the word for
King James Version.
We got a King James right here, bro. And I'll get you a King James Version. Let me get you this version. Get Jeremiah 10:2. I get it. You got it? Read that for me.
Let me read you say
because I think the Pope even participates in decorating the Christmas tree, doesn't he?
Yep.
He does it on TV.
You know those wicked ass holy days coming up, September 20th, the Midnight Host, and that's when they are. Anybody that's against pagan worship, they're punishing those that are against the pagan
one. The churches are holy, they're holy pagan.
I'm not saying that y'all not wrong, I'm just...
Like the Catholic Church, they celebrate Easter. The word Easter, that comes from a Norse goddess. She was the goddess of the spring, the goddess of fertility, and it, which really goes back to the ancient goddess Ishtar. Okay? So it's all paganism. That's why all the priests, they all shave their beards off. Well, that's what Catholicism is, paganism.
I'm Catholic, but I don't step in, you know?
Well, I was just telling you, that's all lies. There's no truth in it. None. I get that Jeremiah 10 too. Because all these Christians do, they all break the commandments of the Lord. Get that. Jeremiah 10.
Everybody's not going to be able to follow all commandments.
But they do it willfully. And they enjoy
it's
breaking
not
it.
Willfully. Everybody has their own choice.
So you going to celebrate Christmas now?
I mean,
after we told you it was wrong?
Everybody has their own belief.
But yeah, it doesn't matter
if
what you believe.
You believe that Christmas is with Jesus, then you believe that Christmas is what Jesus is, not Christmas.
Show me, but
representing Satan, then that's what you believe.
No, it's no belief. It's about fact and fiction. It's a fact that in the ancient world, all the pagan cults worship their chief deity, which is the devil, on December 25th. Because December 25th is a solar day. It's sun worship.
Hey, get that.
Jeremiah 10:1.
Hear ye the word which Yahweh speaketh unto you, O children of Israel. Thus saith Yahweh, learn not the way of the heathen.
Learn not the ways of the heathen, meaning celebrating Christmas and Easter, Halloween, all that madness. Go ahead.
And be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
Be not dismayed at signs of heaven, because December 25th is a sign of heaven, is an astrological date. Because on December 23rd, the sun, actually December 23rd or the 24th, is the shortest day of the year. Okay, meaning there's not that much sunlight. The day is real dark. It's the darkest day of the year. But on December 25th, that's when the days start getting longer again. And by, you know, by a couple minutes each day, you know, the day you get more sunlight. So that's why the pagans started celebrating Christmas, because they was worshiping the sun god.
Like the scripture said.
Yep, go ahead.
Or for heathen or dismayed at the signs of heaven.
And all people don't know that, so that's why we got to come out here and teach.
Right.
Go ahead.
But the heathen are dismayed at them.
Because the heathen get dismayed at the sun. He'll sacrifice animals or people according to, you know, the position of the stars and the sun and the moon. Go ahead.
But the customs of the people are vain.
The customs of the people are vain. Celebrating Christmas is vain. Our customs was not Christmas. The customs of our people, the Israelites, was to celebrate the Passover, to keep the Passover. One of our high holy days just passed. We just observed the Day of Atonement, which was a day of fasting. And when you fasted for a 24-hour period with no food and no water.
And I bet you 100% nobody did
that. No, nobody did that.
100%.
They don't know about it.
That's right.
You know, maybe that's what's in the Bible, not Christmas, not Easter. Because, you know, our people, they can't handle a day of affliction like that.
Hours.
To afflict themselves.
A few hours.
That's one of our chief holy days. The Day of Atonement, okay? That's what we're supposed to celebrate. Keep going.
But the customs of the people are vain, for one cutteth a tree out of the forest.
One cutteth a tree out of the forest. Christmas tree. Keep going.
The work of the hands of the workman with the axe.
Keep going.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
They deck it with silver and gold. That's what they do with the Christmas tree. They take the tree out of the forest.
Silver,
they get the silver and gold. They put their little, oh yeah. Then they put the bulbs on it. Because really the Christmas tree really represents the tree of knowledge and good and evil that was in the Garden of Eden. That's why they put bulbs on it. The bulb represents fruit. That's that forbidden fruit that the serpent gave to Eve. That's what that represents. And then you put gifts under the tree because
God,
they say the serpent
God
is the giver of gifts.
He told Adam and Eve not to eat the fruit of knowledge, which is that tree.
No, not the fruit of knowledge of good and evil.
No. What is the tree, brother? What is
the devil
tree?
Has tempted them to eat the fruit of the tree because
exactly.
He knows.
What is that fruit?
What's that fruit?
Who knows what the fruit is? It's a fruit of knowledge.
The fruit is wisdom, is knowledge, wisdom.
Yes.
Understanding. It's just, what's the word I'm looking for? Speaking in
the fruit that he was eating, though, that's the fruit of all this wickedness. And
but there wouldn't be no sin if Adam and Eve would not have not bitten from that. There would not be no sin.
Christmas tree is, what we're telling you, the Christmas tree is holy satanic. It's satanic. If that's the holiday sanctioned by the rulers of this kingdom, which is Satan's kingdom, then you know it's evil. That's the holiday of your slave master. I mean, bro, if you don't want to follow the Bible, you don't have to. Remember, you claim you got free will, right?
We all have free will. Well, you have free will to follow God and follow Jesus Christ. Or not to follow him.
So
that's
Christmas
why they are atheists.
And you're not following him. You rejected him.
Oh, hell.
You become an antichrist.
I am protecting my beliefs.
What beliefs? That is
makes you an antichrist.
Everybody has their own beliefs.
So do you make cookies for Santa Claus too?
If my child believes in Santa Claus, of course.
Your child believes what you're talking. You know?
And Santa Claus is Baal. That's why he's all red. And he wears a Baal hat. That's literally the same hat the Baal wore. It's very similar to the hat of the Egyptian pharaohs. A little pointy hat with a ball on top.
Well, I catch y'all. I'm not saying that y'all wrong. I'm just saying what I grew up on and what I know about and what I follow about.
Well, you gotta be reborn, bro. You gotta be reborn. You gotta be reborn as a baby. You gotta come back as a baby. You gotta forget all that other madness you was taught, how you was raised. Chances are most of y'all was raised wrong. You gotta be reborn. That's all there is to it.
Chances are.
You was raised wrong. Alright, that's why this Lord said you gotta be reborn. You all of us was raised, I celebrated Christmas when I was a kid. But the scriptures tell you that, you know, that's the wave of the heathens. That's Baal worship, that's devil worship, like straight up. You don't get, there's no more pure form of devil worship than Christmas. That's how, you know about that, right?
Yeah, you're right.
I can just tell the spirit. Like,
yeah, you're right. Well, I already know what you're talking about. That's all God. You're talking about the tree?
Yeah, the tree.
Yeah, that's a
peppermint
stand.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah, because, you know, we was telling some brother about it. He had a problem with it. He didn't want to let go of his old ways.
Now, I was looking at the Bible last night. It said the exact same thing now.
But what I'm saying, what
that's your question. If the U.S. government is terrorist,
why do you
stand?
You need a passport, bro. You a great American.
Just stick with the King James Version.
You love America? Then just walk away.
I fought for America.
Oh, you fought for America. The Navy are a bunch of fucking... I was in the Marines. We made fun of the Navy. We called y'all squids.
Well, you know what? Queen Elizabeth. The Marines couldn't go anyplace unless the Navy gave them a ride. Why do we call our nation terrorists? That's what I want to know.
You gonna cry? You gonna cry, bro?
No. I just want to know why is the government terrorists?
I can't tell you nothing, dude.
No.
They said they found ISIS.
Okay. Let me ask you one question then, bro. How many buildings were destroyed on 9/11?
Because I found a couple.
Well,
Well, wait, in New York, how many buildings collapsed? No, there was three. So you don't even know what's going on, bro. So I can't talk to you. You're clueless. You don't know. There's nothing I can teach you, bro. Yeah, Building 7. Building 7 collapsed, didn't even get hit by a plane. No, bro, no.
You don't listen to
why I want to listen to you?
Why do you want to listen to me? Because I'm asking you me a question. Why do you hate this country being a terrorist?
America's like,
you
America, they're the supreme.
They're invaders, though. They are the invaders.
Exactly.
They invade all the countries.
Exactly.
They are the invaders.
They're oppressors of the entire planet Earth, bro.
Hell, we are the invaders.
Right now, they over in Afghanistan, the United States government, guarding poppy fields. Where's all the heroin coming from, bro?
They're not guarding poppy.
Yeah, they are.
Is she there? I spent 6 years in
pictures.
We burn them down.
You believe in pictures?
Okay, you spent.
Then where's all the heroin coming from?
It does come from there. And a lot of it comes from the CIA.
The CIA
is not government funded.
It's part of the government.
You said this,
right? No, I was in Afghanistan. I went to Afghanistan first and then Iraq.
When?
I went in December of 2001.
Man,
up until 08.
But who? You said CIA got a black budget, right?
Yeah, a lot of it's illegal arms sales and drug sales. You're right.
This is a King James Version. Hey, that's a King James.
I don't give a damn about this country.
Hey. You know, I gotta ask, why are you here?
Teach you the Bible.
No, I mean, why are you here?
No choice.
Somebody just gave their life on those.
Bro, I was in the Marines. Hey, it ain't no big deal.
Yeah, only a couple of years.
How's that a big deal? That's not a big deal, bro. It's nothing to brag about, boast about. That ain't no real fighting. Real fighting is getting killing people with swords and shit. That's manly right there.
Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I mean,
man.
We do. Now we're looking at things from a different point of view.
I'm gonna tell you like this, bro.
But on some of this is propaganda.
I'm a citizen of the Kingdom of Heaven. Okay. America cannot coexist with the Kingdom of Heaven.
And if you read the Bible word for word, and you live it by what it says, and you're trying to apply your life, that's difficult. But America has been, this country was founded on treason.
On treason, exactly. Thank you. Thank you. That's all you got to say? It's all Americanized now, the whole world. You can't escape it.
Yeah, the main ones, the main ones is
Quaidies. I'm not familiar with Quaidies. You familiar with Quaidies?
Kuwait.
What are you talking about? Yeah,
great. He's talking about the Edomites. He's talking about Esau. You know what I'm saying?
Esau's
offspring.
Yeah. Kuwait is close to Israel. It's in modern day Jordan.
Yeah. We'll be right back.
That's why you're the Red Sea, man. They call it the Red Sea because of Esau. It's right by their territory. You know what I mean? Because in the Bible, it's called the Suwak Sea or something, the Reed Sea. I think it's the Hebrew Suwak, Suwak, something like that.
So,
You see our people dumb. Like when the Duke got wanted to kill us because we said the United States government was terrorists. Then I asked him a question about 9/11. I asked him how many buildings got destroyed. He said five.
What?
Well, he said in New York five buildings got destroyed. That's, I ain't never heard that one before.
Let me read this real quick. This is important scripture. Luke 24:24. 14:24. Lord, this is red letters too, so that the servant came to show his Lord these things. Then the master of the house, being angry, said to his servant, go out quickly into the streets and lanes of the city and bring in hither the poor and maimed and the halt and the blind.
You're supposed to come out here and teach, stir shit up. You know what I mean? Cause some controversy.
Blow your trumpets.
Yeah.
I like that controversy.
And actually, by coming out here, we learned by coming out here, you know what I mean? I've never learned as much as I have out here teaching, because you encounter so many different spirits and so many different philosophies.
They say you only live with one nation, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So,
they say
one nation. You know what I'm saying? You know what it is. You know what I mean?
People don't want to hear that, though.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, they hate to hear that, man.
I know I should help. You know what I'm saying?
I gave you a Bible to read. You told my friend you did. My friend did. Man, you ain't getting judged on that right now, man. You ain't getting judged on that right now, but you know.
Now, we ain't got to be all fun. We are, man. We're going to be like the boss.
But it may change the faith. You know what I mean? Faith is above all else. Yeah, right. We ain't eating no pork or nothing like that.
That one way or the other.
Right, exactly. And we still all sin, though, you know. Because in our mind, we want to be perfect. You know what I'm saying? But your body, blessed with you, bro.
Yeah, all have sin and come to the glory of God.
Yep. But we try our best, though, you know what I mean?
That's why we out here. Bro.
In the kingdom, everything going to be made straight. So.
Let me go in there, man.
Because you got a lot of dudes, they'll say you get saved by the law. But we do keep the law. Right, we keep it to the best. So the main thing we stretch is faith.
Like one of the laws is you can't suffer or allow where you live. You can't go out and kill a homeless person.
Yeah, you're supposed to kill back.
Supposed to, you can't allow them to live.
Right.
You can't keep everything. You got to do our best in our village.
Hey, some dudes will bring the Bible bug out and
start killing people. Well, this devil will lock you up, man. Well, that's actually, if we did kill us and get away with it, man, we'd be calling the rest of our life out of this stuff, man. You know? You can't kill these devils, man.
Man, yeah, we're supposed to be spiritual,
yeah. That's right. You know what I'm saying?
I was out thinking about that the other day, like, you know what I'm saying? But say, you know, when the dudes are in heaven, he say, he's seen all the multitude of people, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Awake, you know what I'm saying? He said, God said, vengeance is mine. Yeah. He's talking to the spirits. That's what the flesh and blood, you know what I'm saying, on earth, he says, you know what I'm saying, eye for an eye. You feel me? Across that line.
Remember, the Lord said, too. He said, no longer eye for an eye. And now you're supposed to have that forgiveness. You know, in the Old Testament, there was no forgiveness.
But Jesus came to fulfill the law and not do away with it, you feel me?
Yeah,
so
exactly.
So, what it is. It's a balance, you know what I'm saying? I can't turn the other cheeks and my smack knees when it's warm. You know what I mean?
Right.
But we know what that means, though. We've all been in that situation with something like, be the better man.
Walk. I don't believe that Jesus was going to come.
No, he wasn't.
No, I think you smack him and it's warm.
That's the scripture.
Let me get that, bro.
Mean?
You know the example in the Bible is when he makes a whip?
Let me get it. I got it right here.
Listen to this, man. The Lord was going to come. You know, just like you said, man.
All right.
He was going to come, man.
John 2:13. And the Jews' Passover was at hand, and Yahawashi went up to Jerusalem and found in the temple those that sold oxen and sheep and doves and the changers of money sitting. And when he had made a scourge of small cords, he drove them all out of the temple and the sheep and the oxen and poured out the changers' money and overthrew the table.
That's what it meant.
And said unto them that sold doves, take these things in. Make not my father's house a house.
You want to read that again, bro?
Oh, yeah. It said he made a scourge of small cords. The Lord made a whip. He had a customized whip he made. And he went up in his temple. And everybody was trying to, you know, make money off of the congregation or whatever. He just started whipping. Pushed the tables over. Money spilled all over the floor. He was even hitting the sheep in the eyes.
And them tables were real tables.
Yeah, you know, that wasn't no Walmart table.
The Lord lifted up and, like, he was bugged. Yeah. And the auction itself,
he got them all out of there.
You know, he was bugged.
John 2:13.
Let me get another scripture.
It's all about that balance, though.
Yeah, I'm talking about where I'm inside the radio. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm talking about the people watching the radio. I'm saying, Saudi Arabia. Look at Saudi Arabia. How they said, you know what I'm saying?
Well, I heard that a lot of the Muslims over there in the Middle East, they say that the Saudi royal family are actually crypto Jews or Edomites. You know how Esau claimed to be Jews.
Right.
But they said that the royal family over there, I've heard a lot of people say that they're really crypto Jews. Really
Edomite.
The royal family. The king of Saudi Arabia.
Oh yeah. Who do you think the United States protected? You know what I'm saying?
Oh, they love them.
Man, you see, yeah, you guys, one of them rich over in Saudi Arabia. They run the world. We're king quiet.
Really? The so-called Jews are running shit.
There you go. This is Luke 19.
The Jews.
This is Luke 19:21. For our Pharisees, thou art an austere man. Thou takest up that thou layest not down, and reapest that thou not sow. And he said unto him, out of thine own mouth will I judge thee, thou wicked servant. Thou knewest that I was an austere man,
Lord, all steer feet strip. You take your shit, but you know, what's the image they give you when you watch television? We made a video, man, called Church Hunter.
That's the whole week's week. That was back
in the fun, man. We went to a fucking church. They quick call down there. I'll laugh at them.
That was years ago.
They
make good money.
You
know what they say, you want to get rich, start their own little
add something that really attracts women. Say something.
Mystery. I want the mystery.
2
Timothy 4:2. Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season.
In season is like right now. As long as we out here being seen, we'll put the message out. In season, out of season.
Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering.
That's right, that's an instruction. Ain't nothing better than this is a blueprint. You know, you can't put a building up without a blueprint. And that's a building to build that spiritual building. You know, the blueprint. You know, this is bad, man. It's fun, too, you know. Especially when this is the only time. And I'm 50 years old. And I know. It's the only time around brothers, man. And you know, when we outside of this world, when we outside of this camp, we out in the world, you know, we got the most society out of the world. Man, we ain't nothing around snakes and roaches. You know, niggas that's looking at your woman like, you're not going to work, I'm not going to do it. You know what I'm saying? It's a terrible world. Like yesterday, man, I'm sitting out on the porch reading. Dudes got out distracted, man, across the street, man. Y'all know about this pants falling off. I'm like, I'll just start praying in the Lord, man. Woo! Get on. Deuteronomy 28:60. That's a definite word. That's a ghost word. Yeah, they took
it out. I got a video on my page of the lady.
That you can breathe it in. And its only whole purpose is to weaken your immune system. That's why people can't catch cold, simple, easy, get the flu, whatever, man. Whatever diseases or whatever, it's easy. It's to break down your immune system. Right. Oh, that's bad.
They use it as a reflector.
That's coming. That miracle.
They're going to put a fake fire in the sky. You feel me? And you can see it like, wow, look, there you go.
Oh, hey.
You know what I'm saying? I'm going to let the laser light show. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's going to believe in it.
Oh, that's what's coming. That miracle. Something's going to appear, man. I can't wait, though, man, because I'm excited, really.
mind.
We excited, man. We excited, man.
They say everybody going to run and hide.
Hey, you know what? Some people going to run toward it. Like, they might broadcast a giant Jesus. This, they might.
Yeah, they're going to come out.
Bullshit goes into that.
Okay. They got a book of the giants, they clone and stuff.
They dug up ancient bones of giants. They got ways of beating
DNA out of their bones.
Yeah. This devil's clever, man.